Hello everyone! It's been a while since I made one of these videos where I just sit here and talk to you guys. So since today it's raining and I have some time, I was like, this is the perfect day. I really have something to tell you. As you probably guessed from the title, today we're gonna talk about 5 things to expect if you are in an international relationship. Of course, every relationship is different, but in my experience and talking to my friends who are in an international relationship, I feel like these are some things you might expect. I have 5 points for you guys, but I feel like in each point there is some good and bad. There are some pros and cons. Let's start. Thing number one, I feel like this is so underestimated, but it's probably the most important point, is adapting to a new culture. So if you live in a foreign country, or in my case, if your partner lives in a foreign country, as a partner, you have to help him adapt. Because you might think like, yeah, the new culture is just the language and just a few things, but it's actually everything. It's going to the post office, it's going to the bank, it's talking to the shop assistant at a store, it's choosing a present, it's the etiquette at a dinner table, it's driving, and I can go on and on and on. It's like everything. Of course, you understand, you know, that your partner is adapting to a new culture. And if I lived in America, Brian would have to help me adapt to the American culture. But it's actually a lot, and it can be frustrating both for the person who is getting used to the new culture and for the person who is helping. Because, of course, you can imagine how difficult it can be and frustrating, and you feel like you have to rely on people and you're not independent. So I get it. It's really frustrating. But if you're the other person, it could be frustrating sometimes because it's like, just do it, or oh, I have to do it all myself. But it's important that you are there for them and that you help them and that you're patient, because your partner would do the same. But you rediscover your own culture by having to explain it to your partner, or you learn your partner's culture, you have a better understanding of who they are. It's really interesting. So this is the pro of this point. The second point is traveling. There will be a lot of traveling. This is definitely cool because you always feel like you have a trip planned, blah blah blah. But the disadvantage is that if you have a normal, standard, full-time job and you only have 2 weeks off in August, then you know that instead of exploring every year different countries, you will go to your partner's country, most likely. Not every time, but often. This is probably like a disadvantage because you end up not exploring the world that much because you want to meet your in-laws or your partner's family or friends, etc. But in our case, personally, this is now not a problem because we have flexible jobs, so we are still able to travel even all year round if we wanted to, because I teach online. But I've heard some couples, some friends, it can be a little... You have to know that. You have to be ready for that. The third point is visas. I don't know how there is an advantage to this point, but be ready. Love, just love, won't give you a visa. Brian and I, we've always done our best not to be in a long distance relationship, because I don't have a visa to be in America for more than 3 months, and Brian didn't have a visa to stay in Italy for more than 3 months. We always had to travel, change country, or get a visa to be in Japan together. Even just the pressure of having to get a visa to be in Japan, to live together, it's not really easy, and it can be a little expensive and it can be a long process. Just keep in mind that you might have to be long distance for a while, or you will have to do like us, like crazy traveling in order to always be together. The next point is living away from your family or one's family. This is a thing. It's really sad, actually. It's like the worst thing. Now Brian is here and he loves my family and they love him, but we are not able to see his family as much as we would like to. We would love to have them all in the same place. So far, we've been kind of good, especially this year, at seeing them often. Like, we will go to America in April soon and we'll stay for 3 months. But it's not like every weekend. He can just call his mom and be like, hey, we're coming for lunch, make something. And even if I went to America in the future, it would be the same for me. That sucks. That sucks. Brian and I are family people, and I would love my future children to have all of their grandparents in the same city, not even in the same country, in the same city. So that I could be like, yeah, you have them on Saturday and you have them on Sunday. Kidding. Kidding! And the last point is the language. Now, I'm so lucky because I married a rare American who can speak Italian perfectly. I'm lucky. But sometimes being in an international relationship means that you'll have to learn your partner's language, or maybe you will always speak a foreign language to you, so you have to make an effort to be clear and communicate and understand. But there's like an extra challenge. I hope this video doesn't sound too negative, because it's actually not. Because Brian and I have been so good at handling and understanding all these things. I'm really proud of us. I just want you guys to know that it's not all fun and easy and everything is like perfect. I want to share the real thing here. Being in an international relationship is cool. It's fun. You get to travel. You get to meet different people, different cultures. It's totally entertaining and you never get bored, but it also comes with a lot of sacrifice and challenges. We're happy, but if you're planning on finding yourself a foreign partner, keep these things in mind. Okay? Thank you for watching. I'll see you soon. Bye.